Ladies and gentlemen, I've been asked to say a few words about my racehorse, Maudie. As you know, I entered her for the Grand National. And although Maudie completed the course, I was called away at the canal turn. At the beginning of the race, we had our first troubles because she was awfully eager to get off in front of the other horses and got tied up in the starting tape, and she nearly killed the official starter. Dashing about like a dog with a bone, she wouldn't put him down, you know. It was so embarrassing for me, but our real difficulties started when we got to the fences, because Maudie doesn't jump, you see, and it is so essential in the Grand National, really. And of course, she's a horse that doesn't know what defeat is. If she can't jump a fence, she'll bite her way through it. I mean, if I was offered every fence, I was under them and through them as well. And I'm all for perseverance, but that sort of thing does delay in a race, you know. Oh, we were in and out of Beecher's Brook like a couple of performing seals all afternoon. When I came out for the sixth time and the 4:30 was going over, the dumb insolence of the horses and the insolence of the jockeys was very hard to bear, but of course I'm wrapped up in racing because it is the sport of kings, and I've got royal blood in my veins. Oh, yes, my Aunt Amelia on the Scottish side of the family is directly descended from Flora MacDonald. When she went to the Royal College of Heralds, they told her that if only the young pretender had been a little bit younger and a little more genuine, she'd have been moving in very exalted circles. Of course, we entered Maudie for the Derby, you know, and although she didn't win the race, in fact, she lost herself as well. And I had to walk home, which was very awkward, with all that traffic on the road, you know. Not a single soul offered me a lift, except one awfully nice young fellow in a steamroller in Epsom High Street, and he said to me, "Would you like a lift?" I said, "Well, that's awfully good of you." I said, "Where are you going?" He said, "Well, I'm going to the end of the high street." So I said, "Well, how far would that be?" And he said, "Oh, about 100 yards. And so I said, "Well, where are you going after that?" And he said, "I'm coming back here. I'm just rolling the road." And so I said, "Well, it's awfully good of you, but it does seem rather pointless popping backwards and forwards in a steamroller when you're going up to town." And he was a very reasonable young chap, and he entirely saw my point of view. And he said, "Well, I only offered you the lift because I thought it might make a nice change." I thought it was rather nice of him, don't you think? Oh, don't you? And with the training of Maudie, we decided to train her in town because she is so essentially a town horse. And we chose the Tottenham Court Road just to keep the sort of name of Tottenham or Tatnam before her, to encourage her. And, of course, the unfortunate part is that she lost the Grand National through her inability to jump, but since then, she's done nothing but jump, which is so trying. As soon as we got her on the Tottenham Court Road, the first thing she did was to leap and bound over a taxicab. You know, and the driver was awfully nice about it, and he said, "I don't want to complain in the least, but it is so confusing when you're driving." And of course, he was quite right, you know. And so even while we were talking, she started this bounding and leaping again over the cab. And so finally he said, "Well, I'm awfully sorry, but I'm afraid I must send for a policeman." And of course, neither Maudie nor I could say nay. And so he sent for the policeman, and the policeman's an awfully nice young fellow. And he said, "We're only too pleased for Maudie to train in the Tottenham Court Road, but she really must stop this leaping over the traffic, because it does confuse everybody so." And while I was talking, she sat down in a nearby horse trough and thought it was Beecher's Brook, you see. And on the day of the race, she rushed up to a pillar box at the end of the Tottenham Court Road and got her feet wedged into it. She thought it was the finishing post, you see. And so the fire brigade came along, but they could do nothing. And finally, a postman suggested we put a stamp on her and let her go home by herself, which I did. And in actually sending her to the race course, I sent her by the underground. I thought it would avoid the traffic. But when we got onto the escalator, she got her head down, the blood all ran to her head, and she came off very shaky indeed. But in the race itself, at the beginning of the race, she heard a merry-go-round in the distance, and there's one thing she cannot resist, it's a merry-go-round, and she was over the fence in a flash, you know, and she saw the gaiety and music and the horses rushing round, thought it was the big race, you see, and started boring into the race. And I landed on the pipes of the steam organ, but she actually disappeared, and we haven't heard of her since, and I was wondering if any of you had heard. If you'd let me know, I should be so glad. Thank you.